Stop using kubectl to manage your Kubernetes clusters and instead use K9s, because instead of doing all of this to do port forwarding, I can press Shift F, change this value, and hit enter. So much easier. Of course, K9s can do much more than that, but if you want a quick run through of its main features, then this video is for you. But before we get started, be sure to hit the subscribe button so that others can find this content. Anyway, once you've installed K9s, you should see this table in the middle, cluster, version, and resource information over here, useful shortcut over here, which have been cut off because I've zoomed in, but if I zoom out, you can see more of them, and the breadcrumbs down here. I don't have a metric server in this cluster. That's why there's no CPU and memory information. Also, the colors and theme for my K9s will most likely be very different to yours. I'll explain a bit later why that's the case. Right now, we're looking at pods in the default namespace, but I can view deployments by pressing the colon key to enter command mode, start writing deploy, and you get this nice autocomplete. I can also go to services, namespaces, contexts, and workload to view all the cluster resources. I can filter through resources by pressing forward slash and adding some text, which shows what's been filtered over here. I can also change namespaces before filtering, and I can even change context using the at symbol. And now you can see I have resource stats over here because I have a metric server in this cluster. You may have noticed I only have three namespace shortcuts, even though there are six different namespaces. This is because K9s will add more shortcuts based on the namespaces you visit. So if I visit kube node lease, now you can see that shows up here. Let's go back to the default namespace. And for this resource, so for this pod, I can press L to view the logs, press F to view the logs in full screen. And if you look at the breadcrumbs, I can press escape to go back to the parent. Let's go back to the pod. And in the containers level, we can press S to get shell access to the container. So I can access the Mongo shell and do things like view all the collections, which is empty. So let's view the databases, which we can see has some information. I can use port forwarding on a pod with Shift F, hit OK. And now we can see an F symbol to show that port forwarding is working. I can delete it by pressing the F key to go to port forwards, pressing Control D and going to OK. I can also view the YAML for a pod by pressing Y or edit the YAML by pressing E, which opens the pod in the editor that's configured for my shell. And in deployments, I can change the container image by pressing I. So we can change this to 8.0.5, and that will change the image straight away. And we can press D to describe it, and we can see that the image is now 8.0.5. I could also press S while in deployments to increase the replicas, and that will also update in real time. The shortcuts are different based on the resources that you're viewing, and you can press the question mark key to view all of them. You can also view all the aliases by pressing Control A, or by typing alias in command mode. And these aliases are what trigger commands in command mode, like CRB for cluster role bindings. But you can also create your own custom aliases. Running K9s info in the terminal will give you the location of all the K9s related files. And we can see there's one here for aliases. So if we go to that directory and the aliases file, we can see the custom aliases that have already been added. While we're on the topic of customization, the config file here lets you change a bunch of things like mouse mode, logoless mode, no icons mode, and also you can change the theme or the skin of K9s. This Tokyo Night skin is one that I customize based off a different Tokyo Night skin, and you can get access to my custom Tokyo Night skin from the link in the video description. But you can also find a bunch of other skins from the official K9s repo. So I can change this to Dracula and restart K9s to see the new look. Another cool thing you can do in the config is to enable image scans, which will give you the vulnerability score of a resource in a 5-bit vector. So the position of the 1 value indicates the severity level. And we can view these vulnerabilities by pressing V, and pressing enter over a vulnerability will open it in the browser. Please note, at the time of recording, this is still a preview feature. That's why it's set to false by default, and that's why it takes a while to load up. As awesome as K9s is, when it comes to applying a directory of manifest files, you still have to use kubectl. So if you have kubeends or kubectl installed, don't get rid of that just yet in favor of K9s. But for general cluster management and viewing resources, K9s is still super useful.